2:1 fast set resin. I'm just going to seal this with it so that any moisture in it is okay. Yeah, I know it's a piece of oak, but I found it on the road. Well, it doesn't look like it's going to come off peacefully. But it is going to come off. Okay, so aside from the hot glue, I think we look okay. So, I hope that goes away. It's hit or miss, you know. I didn't want to just let them float in there. Yeah, see if I can clean this up a little bit by hand. I'm just going to put the portion bit in the drill and see if I can straighten that up so it sits flat in the chuck. And we'll get this turning. Thank you.
So the only problem I do have currently is the amount of air bubbles that are in this. I'm not quite sure how I'm going to fix that. I'm going to get to putting a mortise in the bottom and see if I can clean that up some. Most likely I'm going to put one of the little maker coins I got from Bob Cook in the bottom of this because it's clear and translucent. Okay, let me get to that. Okay, although I'm trying to be funny with this, this is really hot. I'm in a plastic bag and I'm overheating, so I'm going to peel this off even though I wanted to peel it. Finish the video. I'm just trying to be funny, so you got to respect the fact that people are in these things. I'm cooking, I'm sweating, you know, I'm in Michigan. It's not actually warm here, you know. I gotta figure out what to do with that and how to repair those holes, but I'm gonna take this off the hook. I'm all wet. I'm just sweating. Yeah, it's wet. I'm wet. 2-1 fast set hardener in total boat. With a little bit of butterscotch coloring in it. I'm just trying to fill all this in. It's not, this is important here. Not so much this, but this is important. Once I put it in the chuck that way, I can't get back to it. So I scuffed this up with 80 grit, and I'm going to clean it off with some denatured alcohol. I know it's not going to look shiny or anything, but what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to coat this with, that's really rough. Maybe I should have went finer. I'm going to coat this with 2-1 fast set resin, and hopefully I can fill the voids. Just dry it out for a minute while I'm mixing this up. This may or may not work. Hope it works. I was hoping it would work. Let's see if we get it filled up here. Oops. That Kim Tippin, she's noisy. Turn her down. All right, so I forgot to push the go button. So it's a little, it's not real sticky, but it's kind of gummy. So I've sharpened the tool up. I'm not sure if it's gonna do what I wanted. I'm just gonna plow through it and see what happens. With that, I'm gonna sand the bottom up and probably spray it with some lacquer. I may leave the holes just like that. I don't think I can do anything with them. Maybe we'll try the brown. I don't have a whole lot of it left, but we'll try the brown. I might be able to do it with these. I don't know. About to find out, aren't we? As long as I could probably get out. And I can't. Dripping it in the garbage. Okay, so a little bit of sandy sand. I'm gonna go through these grits and I'll probably give this a lacquer finish. I know some people don't like it, but it works for me and I like it. So this is way too fast, dummy. Okay, so you get the idea. I'll be back when I get this done. All right, well, I'm not positive. I've sanded this down to, what did I go to, 320. And I keep finding holes, so I'm going to hit it with sand and sealer. I was going to go with Axe and try to smooth this out some more, but I'm a little worried about that getting in the holes and then spraying this with lacquer. So I'm going to leave it as it is. It's going to have little tiny air bubbly holes in it. And we're off. Maybe. right back as soon as we're done sanding. Crosscut Creations. Thank you, Robert. We'll get you on the board right there. And then I got another one from, all right. Yeah, I read that as M the Bitch Woodworking. That's how I read it. How are you guys? The home of the free splinters. Thank you, Matt. We got you on the board right over there. Alright, so, all joking aside, I did not drink resin. That was actually apple pie whiskey. Don't drink resin because it's not good for you. Just my disclaimer. I'll put all those guys in at the end in the description below. Now, we can get to this. Now, the reason I did this... Oh, what's on dirty? I was inspired by a bowl or... type of bowl that Ed did over at Wolf Ridge Woodworks. So I'm going to, put him over there in the corner, and we'll put him at the end and in the description below. So he's the inspiration behind this infectious disease bowl that I made. apparently we can't say the mother words, so I'm not gonna. But that was the idea of this. Now I got some air bubbles in it and some lines, but that was... the whole inspiration into making this was I seen Ed's. And I just changed up the colors. Now I put the pole barn in the bottom with resin with lacquer on it. I think it turned out pretty cool. I like it. And all this was just to be funny in this nightmare we all have going on. So, you know, we're all trapped. Make the best of it, you know. Everybody stay home, stay 60 feet away from each other, you know, because none of us want this, and, you know, it's a little more serious than I think we all think it is. So, I'll put some photos at the end, give her a thumbs up or a thumbs down, and, you know, try to do something. I'm out of the shop, I ain't got nothing better to do, y'all notice I'm just dumping videos. But yeah, go over and check out Ed. Ed does some really nice stuff, actually. So, I'm going to throw him under the bus this week, and we'll do some. I can't help it; they just look like what we see in the pictures, you know. And I thought that when I saw Ed's. So, pictures at the end, and we'll see y'all next week.